Welcome back, guys. I'm Gus, the African Plant Hunter, and this is the second episode I'm doing on this plant. Lemonbush, fever tea, Zumbani in the local language, Lippia, javanica, part of the Verbena family. Very well known in traditional medicine in Southern Africa as a general pick-me-up tonic. It's drunk as a tea. It's called fever tea because when you have a fever, this is the plant you go to. Let me tell you a little bit about some of the chemistry in this remarkable plant. It's got an essential oil, and in the essential oil are a number of volatile compounds, mostly terpenes. And these terpenes are very, very, very interesting. And there's a lot of similarity with cannabis in this plant. No THC, but first one I'm going to talk about as a terpene. So terpenes, as you know, probably know, maybe know, are naturally used by a plant as a defense against disease and against pests. Always interesting from a medicinal point of view, pharmacological point of view. So the first terpene in this plant that is well known and very, very interesting is called myrcene. Myrcene is found in cannabis and well known, documented to treat pain and inflammation. In cannabis, it also is known to expedite the uptake of THC. Myrcene is found in mangoes. The mango myth is the story that if you consume a mango about 45 minutes before you then consume cannabis, the THC will be enhanced. And in fact, that is true. And the reason for that is the myrcene in the mango. Next, compound in this plant, Lippia, is of interest, is linalool. Linalool is the compound that gives lavender its very distinctive odor. Lavender has been used for hundreds of years to help you sleep. Little sprigs of lavender under your pillow at night, and that's because of the linalool. Now, linalool is a powerful anti-inflammatory. It's a powerful analgesic. Insect repellent. It's linalool is used in prevention of fleas and ticks. Linalool also has antifungal and antimicrobial properties. So that's the second compound, second very remarkable compound in this plant, similar to the lavender. And then the third one is caryophyllene, or sometimes known as beta caryophyllene. It's a terpene that's found in clove oil, cannabis, hops. Caryophyllene is the compound that gives black pepper its very distinctive spiciness. And it has the distinction of being the first known dietary cannabinoid that has actually been approved by the FDA for use in foods. So caryophyllene is one of the first cannabinoid compounds other than THC, CBD, CBN to bind directly to the cannabinoid receptors. But what's really interesting about this is that it selectively binds to the CB2 receptors. So you've got CB1 and CB2. The CB1 receptors are the ones that are responsible for the narcotic effect, and the CB2 receptors are the ones associated with atherosclerosis and inflammation. Caryophyllene is therefore a compound that is very useful in a range of medicinal applications because of its ability to bind directly to the CB2 receptors. It's used in the treatment of anxiety, the treatment of depression. It's also used in the treatment of diabetes. And it also, caryophyllene also has known and documented tumor suppressing properties. So I think that's it, guys. I've gone through compounds that I know of in Lippia javanica that have been found by science. This plant has great potential in the treatment of cancer, in the treatment of diabetes, great potential in the treatment of depression and anxiety, and is known for pain, inflammation, as an analgesic, and is the go-to plant when you've got a cough or you've got a cold in our part of the world in Southern Africa. As I said before in a previous episode, sadly it's not technically legal to be sold, in Europe or North America. It hasn't been through the regulatory processes. If you're in Southern Africa, of course you can drink it all the time. It's called Zumbani or fever tea or Lemonbush. Just go and get yourself some next time you're feeling sick, because it is magic stuff. All right, I'm Gus, the African Plant Hunter. It's been fantastic talking to you guys, and I really look forward to talking to you again. I'll catch you later. Bye.